Good morning. Today we are reading from Psalm 88. And I think Psalm 88 is the most somber psalm in all of the Bible. It is maybe the most depressing chapter, if you want to call it a chapter, in the Bible. It is a lament with no hope. It's got a little bit of hope maybe in the beginning. I would say the only highlight that there is in this psalm is the fact that the psalmist prays to God. The rest is very, very negative. And I want to look at this very negative psalm, and I want you to bear with me in our devotional today as I'm going to read through most of the verses of the psalm. There's about 18 of them. Just to bear with me and hear what is going on in this psalm, and then we're going to look as if we can find some answer to this. It says, Lord, you are the God who saves me. Day and night I cry to you. May my prayer come before you. Turn your ear to my cry. So we find the starting of the psalm here is that God, you are the one who saves me. Day and night I cry to you. So you are my Savior. So he's talking about a person that calls to God, that prays to God. He says, my prayer comes before you. Turn your ear to my cry. I'm overwhelmed with troubles and my life draws near to death. I'm counted amongst those who go down to the pit. I'm like one without strength. I'm set apart with the dead, like the slain who lie in the grave, whom you remember no more, who were cut off from your care. So he's simply saying that, God, I'm coming to you. I'm praying to you. You are the one that saves me. And I want to just explain my situation. I am seen as one. I have been counted amongst those. And that would be maybe amongst other people or friends or so forth and say, I'm counted amongst those that go down to the pit. I'm busy dying, going into death. I'm like one that is without strength. I'm set apart with the dead. I'm already seen as part of those that die, that will not live. Isn't that terrible? Those whom you remember no more. And these people, they believe that once you've died, God doesn't remember you. And once you've died, you are cut off from the care. It says, you've put me in the lowest pit, in the darkness of depths. Your wrath lies heavily on me. You've overwhelmed me with all your waves. You've taken me from my closest friends and have made me repulsive to them. So he says, God, you've taken me away from my friends. You've made me repulsive to them. I'm confined and cannot escape. My eyes are dim with grief. I call to you, Lord, every day. I spread out my hands to you. Do you show your wonders to the dead? So what he's simply saying is, I'm dying here. And once I'm dead, your wonders aren't shown. Because once I've died, and what most of the people in the Old Testament believe is that they didn't believe in an afterlife the way we believe in it. I've read through many of the Psalms, and I find the idea that the people thought that when they died, then they died. And then once they're dead, the Bible says, do the dead praise you? The dead knows nothing, and so forth. So it says here, do you show your wonders to the dead? So he's saying, God, I'm dying here. And once I'm dead, you're not showing any wonders to me. It says, do their spirits rise up and praise you? Is your love declared in the grave, your faithfulness in destruction? Are your wonders known in the place of darkness and your righteous deeds in the land of oblivion? It says, no, it is not. I'm already entering into it. My life is no testimony of your goodness the way I am. I am, and what he's likening himself with is that he's already entering into oblivion, into eternal death. And he's saying, I'm already in it. I'm entering into the gates of death. Is what I am going through of any glory to you? Is this the showing of wonders? Is this glorious to your name? He says, even if it is the case that your faithfulness is not shown in destruction, that your wonders is not known in the place of darkness, I still cry to you for help in the morning, and my prayers come before you. Why, Lord, do you reject me and hide your face from me? So we find a person here that is in the deepest lament, and I think there are some people that will be able to identify with the psalmist here. People that are maybe in the deepest of sickness and despair and financial distress or losing of loved ones and whatsoever. You might be here lamenting with the psalm writer here. Why, Lord, do you reject me and hide your face from me? From my youth. Listen to this. And I want to warn you, the psalm doesn't end with hope, but we're going to look at hope. From my youth, I've suffered and have been close to death. I've borne your terrors and I'm in despair. So he's even now saying God is bringing this on him. It's your terrors. Your wrath has swept over me. Your terrors have destroyed me. All day long, they surround me like a flood. They have completely engulfed me. You have taken me from my friends and neighbors. Darkness is my closest friend. Isn't that absolutely sad? And that is the last of the verse in the psalm. Now, how do we answer that? How do we look at that? How would that even be part of the Bible? You know, it looks as if there's so many accusations, so much despair. Now, I do think it's important to read Psalm 80 and 81 with this psalm, because you need to understand that Psalms is written in five different books and every segment has got a certain message. And the key part in Psalm 81 for me is, it says, but my people would not listen to me. Israel would not submit to me. So I've given them over to their stubborn hearts to follow their own devices. If my people would only listen to me, if Israel would only follow my ways, how quickly would I not subdue their enemies and turn my hand against their foes? So we find the same lament in Psalm 80, more or less the same. There was a little bit more hope there. And all the good that was in Israel was taken from Israel in their disobedience to God. And they were just destroying their own lives by their own wisdom. Then they accused God, and God comes in Psalm 81 and says, listen, just listen to me. And when God says, listen to me, he says, listen to my message of grace. Listen to my message of love. Don't live in condemnation and despair. Know you are the city of God. Know that you are loved. See my promises. Believe my love for you. Rest in my love. Like I've said on this last Sunday's message, listen to the goodness of God until your mind goes to rest at his faithfulness. Listen to that. And you'll find God bring deliverance for you. Now, we can use this in a way where we want to just run after the prosperity gospel and all of that. That's not what I'm getting at. What I'm saying here is that there is times when a person can go into the darkest, deepest place where you feel that everything in your life is because of God. But the answer still remains and is that God is not the author of that, that God is the one that gives life and hope. And we will find the psalmist or the person that edited the Psalms put it all together very beautifully. He took Psalm 88 and left it just like that and then skillfully added in Psalm 89. And if you read into Psalm 89, it says the following, I will sing of the Lord's great love forever. With my mouth, I will make your faithfulness known through all generations. I will declare that your love stands firm forever, that you have established your faithfulness in the heavens itself. And you've said, I've made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant, I will establish your line forever and make your throne firm through all generations. Isn't that absolutely powerful? So I want to say this to you. If you are stuck in Psalm 88, you might be at a place where you feel you accuse God, you're against God, God, you brought this to me. Why have you not answered? I think Psalm 88 is basically where the big thing is, the big question is always about why is there evil in the world if God is good and so forth. But we find that your world can be, from young, I've been close to death. You've taken away all my neighbors. You've taken away all my friends. I'm heavy under the wrath of God. God, I cry to you. You, the one that must save me. I'm now about to enter death. How will my life ever bring any glory to you whatsoever? What God is saying, just hear, and I think a person that's at that place, at least praying to God, is at a good place. Because after death, there's resurrection. There is Psalm 89, which is, I will sing of the Lord's great love forever. With my mouth, I will make your faithfulness known through all generations. And what did God say? God said, listen, all the trouble that you were in is not me. It is not me bringing it over you. And when we read the Psalms, we need to always be at a place where we, or when we read any text in the Scripture, where we can find a person giving his opinion, writing it down, speaking, saying God has done this. We need to give God word as well. God says in Psalm 81, it's not him, and that he's there to be good to them. So yes, you might be in that place. You might know people that are in the place where they accuse God. Don't try and explain everything. Love them. Speak the word of God's love towards them. Live the love of God towards them. And as they hear the goodness of God, they will look back and say, the bad wasn't God. It has always been, it had something to do with self or just this broken world. But at the end of the day, God is the Savior. Amen. Well, these are difficult psalms, difficult things to deal with. We've taken a bit of a long time in our devotional today to talk about this. But meditate on this. Pray on this. If you've got something more that you can add to what I've taught here, please feel free to contact me and share it with me. Let us pray. Father, thank you that even if we are at a place in our lives where we are stuck in Psalm 88, where we feel my life and what's happening to me, my poverty, the disgrace in my life, the sin I struggle with, the sickness and disease I have, the negative things that's happening to me every day can bring no glory to you. Lord, it feels as if I'm under your wrath. It feels as if you're not blessing me. My life is just being destroyed and that I'm entering into death. But I call upon you day and night, and it feels as if you are rejecting me. Father, if there are people that are there, I thank you, Lord, that their eyes can be lifted up and know that joy comes in the morning and that there is, after death, the promise of resurrection, and that, yes, God's glory can be shown in death by being raised from the dead. And that is what we find in Psalm 89. We will praise you forever. Thank you, Lord, that no darkness is so dark that you cannot reach us and bring hope to us. Amen and amen. God bless.